join in with the opening responses. Please join in with the words in bold. God is spirit.
Let us worship him in spirit and truth.
The Lord is with us.
Let us praise his name together.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord is here.
His spirit is with us.
Jesus Christ, whom we worship, is our crucified, risen, and ascended Lord, and we have walked with him through his journey of love. We have faced the agony of his suffering and death on a cross. We have rejoiced at his bursting free from the bonds of death. We have enjoyed his risen presence with us, and his revelation of himself through the breaking of bread. We have seen his return to the throne, before which every knee shall bow, and every tongue confess that this is Jesus is Lord. And now, with the followers of his own time, we await the coming of the promised Holy Spirit, his gift to his people, through whom we make Christ known to the world. Let us pray. Come,
Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful people, and kindle in us the fire of your love, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
So we take a moment to call to mind those things which we regret. The Spirit of the Lord fills the world and knows our every word and deed. Let us then open ourselves to our Lord and confess our sins together. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the broken in heart. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You make one by your Spirit the torn and divided. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Father forgive you by the death of his Son, and strengthen us to live in the power of the Spirit all our days.
Amen.
So we say the Gloria together. Glory to God
in the highest.
And peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray that the Spirit will work through our lives to bring Christ to the world. Holy Spirit, sent by the Father, ignite in us your holy fire.
Strengthen your children with the gift of faith.
Revive your church with the breath of love. And renew the face of the earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for our meeting.
From the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verses, beginning of verse 1. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place, and suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams, even of my slaves, both men and women. In those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy, and I will show portents in the heavens above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall return to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day, that everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The Lord is here.
Thank you, Jenny. It's the toughest reading of the year, the Pentecost one. You read it brilliantly, thank you. Please stand for the Gospel reading. Alleluia, alleluia. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful people and kindle in them the fire of your love.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, my Lord.
Jesus spoke to his disciples, "When the Advocate comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who comes from the Father, he will testify on my behalf. You also are to testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have said these things to you, so that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told you about them. I did not say these things to you from the beginning, because I was with you. But now I am going to him who sent me. Yet none of you asks me, 'Where are you going?' But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will prove the world wrong about sin, and righteousness and judgment. About sin, because they do not believe in me. About righteousness, because I am going to the Father, and you will see me no longer. About judgment, because the ruler of this world has been condemned. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth, for he will not speak on his own, but will speak whatever he hears, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May I speak in the name of the living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. When I was a teenager, our vicar, David, would take us on all sorts of water sports adventures. We would go canoeing, kayaking and sailing. We did a pilgrimage to Bradwell. We followed the route of the Celtic Northern Saint Sed in boats up the river. We did windsurfing, did lots of exciting things on the water. Things weren't always so exciting though. One time we visited a sailing lake with a marina that was inland. We had a new boat that Reverend David wanted to try out, and he went off in his new boat with some of the group, and my friend Amy and I were given a small boat to sail on the lake together, and off we went on our little adventure. We sat and we waited. There was not one wisp of wind. The lake was utterly calm. There was no wind whatsoever. It was my first experience of the doldrums. It was boring. It was frustrating. No matter what we did to try and catch the wind, filling out the sails as much as we could, using the oars to change our position, nothing caught. We just sat there. The water gently lapping the sides of the boat seemed to taunt us. We weren't going anywhere. After a few hours, we ended up having to row our boat back to shore and gave it up as a bad day on the water. This last year has felt like a whole year in the doldrums, hasn't it? One would perhaps think that it could be quite lovely sitting on a quiet lake, listening to the water lap the sides of the boat, but when you've set out to have a little adventure, there is nothing worse. This is what the pandemic has been like. We might have thought, finally, I've got time to do those jobs I've been meaning to do, or how nice that I can stay at home and still get paid. But that feeling really didn't last very long, did it? We didn't choose what happened to us. Just like my friend Amy and I, we set out on an adventure and we were literally stopped in our tracks. The Holy Spirit is someone who is quite hard to talk about. I've often heard people say to me, I understand God the Father, and Jesus of course, but I don't really get the Holy Spirit. The early Christians used metaphors to talk about the work of the Spirit, and we hear the account in Acts describe something that's like wind and something that's like flames of fire. These are not necessarily literal, but it was the only language that they could use to describe what they had experienced. What we miss in English is that the Greek word for spirit, pneuma, which is where you get the word pneumatic from, with the air in tyres and things, it also means wind or breath. So it's kind of got a double meaning. So we should perhaps call it the Holy Breath. There is an obvious link between the Holy Spirit and the breath God breathes into Adam at his creation. And if you remember, the breath that Jesus breathes into the disciples in the upper room after his resurrection, when he says, receive the Holy Spirit, and he breathes on them. This is illustrated beautifully by C.S. Lewis in The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe. Do you remember how the White Witch has turned a lot of the Narnians to stone, including Mr. Tumnus, the fawn? And Aslan goes with Lucy and Susan, and they watch Aslan breathe on all the stone people, and they slowly receive new life and become their old selves again. So the Holy Spirit is the very essence of life, the essence of God. It's the thing that makes us whole, makes us breathe. Something that we don't really think about because it's always there. There's an old story that goes something like this. There are these two young fish swimming along, and they happen to meet an older fish swimming the other way who nods at them and says, morning boys, how's the water? And the two young fish swim away for a bit, and then eventually one of them looks over at the other and goes, what the hell is water? The Holy Spirit is not only described as the breath of God, but also as a violent rushing wind. Change comes with wind. We've had quite a lot of wind, haven't we, this last week? Remember that Mary Poppins arrives when the wind changes. Now, if I asked you to draw a picture of the wind, it would be the same as my asking you to draw a picture of the Holy Spirit. Because you can see the effects of the wind, but you can't see the wind. You might draw a tree bowing low in the wind, or a kite flying high, or a boat with its sails full. The wind changes all the things in its path. It can be unpredictable, it can be frightening, it can be exhilarating. Experiencing the Holy Spirit can be all of these things. I remember the first time I tried windsurfing. Once I caught the wind in the sail, I was flying with exhilaration over the water like this. And that wasn't until I realised I didn't have a clue how to turn around. I was going out into the horizon like, absolutely thrilling experience, but also very frightening. In John's Gospel, Jesus teaches Nicodemus about the Spirit, and he says, the wind blows where it pleases. You hear its sound, but you cannot tell where it comes from or where it is going. So it is with everyone born of the Spirit. We heard the story a few weeks ago of the baptism of the Ethiopian eunuch. Remember that it is the Holy Spirit that drives Philip to go to the desert road to meet that man, somewhere rather scary. It is the Holy Spirit that drives Jesus into the wilderness after his baptism. The Spirit often pushes us out of our comfort zone. An early image of the church was that of an ark or a big boat, a place of safety from the storms of life. Most old church buildings look like an upturned boat, if you look at our sort of ceiling. And that's why the central part of the church where you're all sitting is called the nave. It actually comes from the Greek word for boat, which is naos, which is where also we get the word navy from. And today we celebrate the birthday of the church. And here we are in our little boat. It's been stuck in the doldrums this past year. We've tried our best and occasionally been able to catch a bit of wind to move us forwards. We've also tried other ways of propelling ourselves forwards. Now, though, we need to raise our sails and allow the Holy Spirit to fill them again, to lead us forwards into the unknown, with that promise of Jesus echoing in our ears, "I am with you always, to the ends of the age." So let's raise our sails with hope and catch the wind of the Holy Spirit, who brings change and new life and excitement and adventure. Let us allow the Holy Spirit to be breathed into us again, filling us again, refilling our batteries, topping us up, because we're all a bit prone to leaking, aren't we? When Paul writes, "Be filled with the Spirit," in his letter to the Ephesians, what he actually writes in the Greek is, "Keep on being filled with the Spirit. Keep coming back for more." Let us each keep being filled with the Holy Spirit. We come to church each week to be filled anew. So let's see where the Holy Spirit will take us next. Amen. Amen. Please would you stand as you are able as we say the creed together, and as we read it, we might want to think especially about that very last paragraph, about the work of the Holy Spirit and what the Holy Spirit does. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We pray for God to fill us with his Spirit. Generous God, we thank you for the power of your Holy Spirit. We ask that we may be strengthened to serve you better. Lord, come to bless us. and fill us with your Spirit. We thank you for the wisdom of your Holy Spirit. We ask you to make us wise to understand your will. We pray for the work of our PCCs and our upcoming annual meetings as we prepare for our new curate's arrival. We pray for wisdom. Lord, come to bless us
and fill us with your Spirit.
We thank you for the peace of your Holy Spirit. We ask you to keep us confident of your love wherever you call us. Lord, come to bless us
and fill us with your Spirit.
We thank you for the healing of your Holy Spirit. We ask you to bring reconciliation and wholeness where there is division, sickness, and sorrow. And we think especially of our brothers and sisters in the Holy Land. And we pray by name for those in our own community in need. Wyatt and Garrett Ruthven, Barbara Needham, Veronica Blackwell, Margaret and Jim Gilmore, Luke Firth, Chloe Parks, Betty Wood, Jean Naylor, Robert Verity, Lily Wood, Richard Abbas, Margaret Malpass, Mark Bolton, and Susan Prophet. Lord, come to bless us
and fill us with your Spirit.
We thank you for the gifts of your Holy Spirit. We ask you to equip us for the work you have given us. Lord, come to bless us and fill us with your Spirit. We thank you for the fruit of your Holy Spirit. We ask you to reveal in our lives the love of Jesus. Lord, come to bless us
and fill us with your Spirit.
We thank you for the breath of your Holy Spirit given us by the risen Lord. We remember especially those who have recently died. Hazel Herrington, Carol Sims, Kathleen Miller, Patrick Elmore, and Stuart Buckingham. We ask you to keep the whole church, living and departed, in the joy of eternal life. Lord, come to bless us
and fill us with your Spirit.
Generous God, you sent your Holy Spirit upon your Messiah at the River Jordan and upon the disciples in the upper room. In your mercy, fill us with your Spirit. Hear our prayer and make us one in heart and mind to serve you with joy forever. Amen. Please, would you stand for the peace? God has made us one in Christ. He has set his seal upon us, and as a pledge of what is to come, has given the Spirit to dwell in our hearts. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So we offer one another a sign of peace.
Thank you.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
And resurrection, you have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world.
Lord of all one, help us to work together for that day when your justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth and your kingdom comes. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms and bring us with Mary, Mother of our Lord, John the Baptist, St. James, and all the saints to be with you forever at your table in heaven. Through Christ.
Save family group, if you've not, go to the waypoints together.
going to finish with the blessing of night. So here's our Easter candle, our Paschal candle for this year. And this has remained at the front of church for the Easter season, and after today it will go and take its place by the pond ready for the baptisms that we'll have later in the year. So let us pray. Blessed are you, Sovereign God, overflowing in love. With Pentecost dawns the age of the Spirit. Now the flame of heaven rests on every believer. Strong and weak, women and men tell out your word. The young receive visions, the old receive dreams. With the new wine of the Spirit, they proclaim your reign of love. Amid the birth pangs of the new creation, the way of light is made known. Source of freedom, giver of life, blessed are you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God forever.
So just as when each of you were baptised, if you've been baptised, you would have been given a lit candle so that you can go and shine as a light in the world. We say that, don't we, to the children, shine as a light in the world to the glory of God the Father, and that's what we're doing. The Holy Spirit rests on each one of us. So we will carefully light our candles. You can take these home with you if you would like. Spirit is always with you, especially in those dark places. So please would you stand as you are able. Be careful not to set fire to your order of service. That happened at Christingle once. I was at Christingle and a brownie set fire to her order of service with her Christingle as we were all singing Shine Jesus Shine. It was a bit dramatic, so just be a bit careful. Lovely, so we're ready for the commission. Now we're going to struggle slightly to turn the page, but the answer is we will to each of these questions. For 50 days we have celebrated the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ over the powers of sin and death. We have proclaimed God's mighty acts, and we have prayed that the power that was at work when God raised Jesus from the dead might be at work in us. As part of God's church here in Barlborough and Clam, I call upon you to live out what you proclaim. Empowered by the Holy Spirit, will you dare to walk into God's future, trusting him to be your guide?
By the Spirit's power, we will.
Will you dare to embrace each other and grow together in love?
We will.
Will you dare to share your riches in common and minister to each other in need?
We will.
Will you dare to pray for each other until your hearts beat with the longings of God?
We will.
Will you dare to carry the light of Christ into the world's dark places?
We will.
The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Today we have remembered the coming of God's power on the disciples, and we invite that same Spirit to drive us out into the wild places of the world. And so may the Spirit who hovered over the waters when the world was created bring into you the life he gives.
Amen.
May the Spirit who overshadowed the Virgin when the eternal Son came among us make you joyful in the service of the Lord.
Amen.
May the Spirit who set the church on fire upon the day of Pentecost bring the world alive with the love of the risen Christ.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and always.
Amen.
And so, filled with the Spirit's power, go in the light and peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.